wishing for beats with plenty bass and lyrics set in haste. If its meaning doesn't manifest, put it to rest. I am a poet. You try to show it, yet blow it. It takes intention for fresh communication, reservation. That is to see without speaking. Take off your coat, take notes. I am deep class or school, cause you need school. I am not a king or queen. I rule. This is an introduction. Small, basic to go to those that know of. No, they might know of you. And I see you. And maybe your gang. But one thing's for sure. Neither will they all pay. Cause you, I'm like an arrow. Got you. Because say something now. You seem to be the type that only understand the annihilation and destruction of the next man. That's not poetry. That is insanity. It's simply fantasy. Far from reality. Poetry is the language of imagination. Poetry is a form of positive creation. Difficult vision is the point. You're missing it. Your face is in front of my hand, so I'm dissing it.
Yo, tell them what time it is with that, man.
No dedication. Just want to give a shout-out. This is a shout-out. My girl's right. Birthday today, Kathy Stanley. We at the gas, like.
All right, give me.
We about to party. You know, drink some Andre, Moed, whatever.
Come on, give that to these people up here on the mix, though.
Oh, yo, what's up? They K-Day, huh?
Yeah, man, the OGs, man, the ones who brought K-Day.
No, I ain't got no radio in my car, can't hear nothing.
That's all right, yo, the people who brought straight-up hip-hop to Los Angeles, man, give them that.
They get much props, yo.
All right, my man Fuzzy in the house representing Julio G. Uh-oh, Tony G's coming on.
I never let the mic magnetize me no more. But came in the door, I said it before. I never let the mic magnetize me no more. Came in the door, I said it before. I never let the mic magnetize me no more. But came in the door, I said it before. I never let the mic magnetize me no more. Bite me, bite your rhyme. I can't pull it back. I'm looking line to line, taking off my coat, clearing my throat. The rhyme will be kicking in till I hit my last note. My rhyme remains a fine, all kind of ideas. Self-esteem makes it seem like a kid took years to build, but still say a rhyme after the next one. Prepared, never said, I'll just press one. And you know that I'm the solo win, so Eric B, make a clap to this. Make a clap to this. I'll be acting ill, no tricks in 86, it's time to build. Eric B, easy on the cut, no mistakes allowed. Cause to me, MC, me move the crowd. I made it easy to dance to this. But can you detect what's coming next from the flex of the wrist? Say indeed, then I proceed, cause my man made a mix. Every beat, he won't be no band-aid to fix his fingertips. No, my rhyme is true, there's no rhymes left. I hurry up because the cut'll make me bleed to death. But he's kicking it, plus it ain't no half-stepping. The party is live, the rhyme can't be kept inside of me. The rhyme is like a volcano. It ain't the everyday style or the same old rhyme, cause I'm better than the rest of them. Every beat is on the cut, and my name is Rock. Thank you. check out my melody, hand out a cigar. I'm letting knowledge be born, and my name's the R. A.K.I.M. not like the rest of them, I'm not on the list. That's what I'm saying, I got minds like a scientist. My melodies in the code, the very next episode. Has the mic off and distorting, ready to explode. I keep the mic at Fahrenheit, freezing seeds to make them colder. The listener's system is kicking like solar. As I memorize, advertise like a poet. Keep you going when the flow is smooth enough. You know it, but rough. That's why the mural on my story, I tell a B. Nobody beats the R. Check out my melody.
We are doing it on Power 106. It's the OG KDAY mixes. We got Gray Mac in the house. We got my man Julio G in the house. And we got Eazy-E in the house.
Yo,
we got Tony G on the turntables right quick. And we got on the microphone and on the telephone my man Clientele from the record crew. What's going on, man?
Yo, what's up, everybody out there? How you doing, Baker Boy?
Man, this Friday Night Flavors at its best. I'm telling you, we're giving dap to the original grandfathers. I don't want to say we're grandfathers, man.
Don't say that.
Because these guys ain't even that old, you know what I'm saying?
How about the architect?
Architects of hip-hop in Los Angeles, man. Eazy-E, what's going on, bro?
What's up, man?
How you doing?
I'm all right.
Welcome
dude.
To the show. Welcome back to the Friday Night Flavor Show as we give dap to everybody who started hip-hop in Los Angeles. Clientele, what's going on, homeboy?
I'm just chilling, man. Hey, listen to the show, man. Y'all sounding great. I just want to say, you know, Baker Boys, y'all doing it, man. You're live. I listen to you every morning on your morning show.
Uh-huh.
You're in the house.
Uh-huh.
You know, you're keeping that hip-hop and that rap movement going.
Well, we trying to do it.
Yeah, and I just want to say, you know that... I'm giving shouts out to all my boys over at K-Day, the original mix masters, everybody who not only kept the West Coast movement going, but the East Coast movement. Definitely we can't go without, you know, my boy Greg Mack.
All right, man.
If it wasn't for Greg, a lot of us, you know, would be...
Give a round of applause, man.
Hey, man. I take a bow, but my jeans are too tight, man.
Well, man, thanks a lot for showing your love and calling us up, man, because you guys are definitely a part of the whole thing that happened here in Los Angeles, and you are definitely inspiration for what's going on in the 94 these days. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
All right. God bless your clientele in the house. Hold on, bro, baby. We got my man, Eazy-E. What brings you up here this evening, bro?
Greg and Tony and Julio.
Yeah. Yeah, man.
You know that.
Because you was back in the days. I remember my man coming back to Bakersfield talking about, man, I was at the Casa Camino Real, and these guys called NWA and Eazy-E threw out this record called Boys in the Hood.
That's right.
I think I told you that last time when you came up here, man.
Right.
And that was my first record legends of you showing hip-hop in Los Angeles, and these guys put it straight on the radio for you, bro.
That's right.
That's right. All right, man. We're going to come right back after this and show some more love for the KDEY Mixmasters, the OG people in the place to be. My man, Greg Mack. We got my man, Julio G, Tony G, and Eazy-E in the place to be with the Baker Boys on Power 106. Straight up hip hop. It's course is where hip hop lives. All right. Hold on, y'all.
You haven't heard that.
What's going on? Back in effect, 11 o'clock at KBWR, Los Angeles. You are tuned in to Friday Night Flavors on Power 106. Boom, banging in your box for your 4th of July weekend. And we started off with this very special show. It's the K-Day reunion, man. And these guys have not actually, you couldn't even call the reunion because these guys have been tight together for from the beginning to now. Now, we got someone on the phone line, but we better get them on before they have to go right quick. We got my man Kev Love. What's going on, Big Daddy?
What's up, homie?
Go give you a shout out to your peoples right now. Go ahead.
Baby, everybody at Terminal Island kicking and listening to Power 106.
Word them up. Hey, answer me this question. How'd you get on the phone, man?
Hey, you know what I mean? I had a bum rush. My buddy up the phone and said, call my wife. Said, give me that number to the radio station. I said, my homeboy's out there. We back from the old school.
Hey, man, go to give your love to the OG K-Day Mixmasters, man.
Hey, KDAY in the mix. The original OG Mixmasters in the house. Tony G, Julio G, and Joe Cooley.
Yeah.
And with Greg Mack, he owe me $300.
All right, my man, Kev, thanks for calling up, Big Daddy. Hold on, stay right there if you can. We got...
phone check, fool.
Hey, the phone check. Man, we got Tony G in the house, you know what I'm saying? I mean, the brightest figure I could say of, you know what I'm saying? When I came and started listening to K-Day, I mean, Tony G was the ultimate to me, you know what I'm saying? You were the epitome of a DJ to the Baker Boys, and that's what inspired us to be on the radio, and inspired us to actually get started in the cutting and mixing. When I heard you do It's Time, bro, that was the ultimate to me. Now, explain to me how rap has changed, you know what I'm saying? How do you think the that rap has evolved from when you started DJing, you know what I'm saying, and playing rap music and rocking parties to these days, man, if it's different at
all. Well, it hasn't changed much. The parties have changed because back in the day, you used to just squab. Nowadays, you just get killed. You got to be real careful sometimes. But there's still people out there that want to party, get the little mix on.
Yeah.
Hip-hop, man, back when I was a kid, I used to play a lot of New York stuff, too, sometimes, because it wasn't really out here. When some of the stuff is similar to some of the stuff now, but everything's gotten so pumped up, man. I mean, all the new groups, the Wu-Tang, the Beatnuts, the whole, you know, the whole New York sound has changed. The L.A. gangster sound, the L.A. hip-hop, it's come a long way, man. People couldn't even imagine listening to L.A. music on the radio. It was so hard to even get on the radio after KD got off.
Right.
It was incredible.
No one wanted to play any hip-hop music, any rap music at all, you know what I'm saying?
And we got songs, I mean, number two, number three in the country that are from L.A.
Yeah.
L.A. hip-hop, L.A. groups, even Lil Warren G just blowing up from L.A., you
know? You know what I'm saying? I mean, already went a million
LBC, songs. You know what I'm saying?
LBC is now, and they went a million, you know what I'm saying, in 2 weeks.
Definitely.
You know, and this is all of Los Angeles, you know, this is West Coast music, you know. Could you compare back in the days when you guys started, I mean, the West Coast and the East Coast, how did you guys deal with that? There was nothing to deal with back then.
We went down there and turned them out. That was it.
Wait, DJing-wise?
DJing-wise, definitely.
Let's talk about that, man. Hold on, we got somebody at the door. Let's talk about that, because there was new music seminars, there was these DJ contests, the DMC music battles and stuff like that, where DJs got, how long, because you were there, I wasn't there, you know.
Yusuf was the first one to go to compete for L.A.
For DJ and Supremacy.
For in Supremacy, then I went the year after, and I got up there with some of the DJs. Everybody thought I was from New York. Everybody thought I was from the Bronx because I knew all the people from out there, the Zulu Nation and Melly Mel, Scorp. They always had my back. And we went up there, and they looked at us like we was a bunch of suckers. I went up against, King Cut?
DJ Cheese.
He went up there doing a little mix. They were taking pictures with his trophies and all that and all that. He got smoked first round. I was the first one to get a perfect 10 at the seminar.
Uh-huh.
They never had nobody get a perfect 10 across
the
board.
Now, back in the days, if you were going for a DJ Supremacy, what was the contest? What did it consist of? A real DJ, not no, you know what I'm saying?
You had two minutes. Cut the record, you had to mix the record, you had to do some tricks with the record. You couldn't be off beat. Your tricks, you could be as fast as hell, but if you weren't on beat, you got no love. I mean, everybody was in there. The whole mix was a little different. Now DJs, they got the speed and they're quick, but their consistency with the timing and
They give them like 5 minutes or something like that to do something.
Yeah, but
with.
It's too hard. I mean, what could you do with trick-wise? I mean, dudes, now there's some fellas out there doing tricks that are incredible, man. And they can't do that in 5 minutes. That's just for show. You know, do some nice DJ cut. Then you got the DJs that are the club DJs doing the mixes and got the dope mix on. They know what's up with the underground, with the thing. They got some dope.
Remember
dope
the guy that used to mix with a bicycle?
Oh, man, it's unicycle, dude, standing, jumping over the turntables
everything,
where they were mixing.
Everything. People don't realize, I mean, the DJ is the person who's going to make you dance when you go out to a club or you go out to a party spot, you know what I'm saying? The DJ who's going to cut the right record in at the right time and stuff like that.
Well, yeah, it was a whole different scene, man. I mean, Joe Cooley went the year after. He blew smoke over there. They couldn't even believe the stuff he was doing. He was so fast. He was the fastest thing they ever saw.
Yeah.
They never saw nobody faster than
and
that.
And they discriminated against him because he was from the West Coast?
He was from the West Coast. It was the East Coast versus West Coast. And if it wasn't for West Coast, East Coast wouldn't have sold all the records they sold
because
they were out there selling the little something-somethings, and we came out here, we blew them up. Greg Mack started bringing them concerts out here, flying them out here, having the time, and the records just blew up so much. That's when they started LL going a million sold, Run-DMC, millions and millions sold, but it all came from over there, but hell, this place blew it up.
We brought it here to Los Angeles. Well, actually, KDAY brought it to Los Angeles, the originators of hip-hop, and I can't say that enough. That's why we're having this show right here today, to give you guys love and give you guys that and the respect that you deserve. Now, records being East Coast and West Coast and stuff, one of the first hip-hop artists that came out of here was, you know what I'm saying, with Eazy-E, man.
Oh,
and
yeah.
He brought something to straight off the streets of Compton.
He bought 8-Ball Rolling. He bought all, he bought everything to the Skateland USA, man. Dope, man, over to Skateland USA. We busted it right there live.
We were playing at Casa one night when this little guy walked in.
You were doing what?
We were playing at the Casa one night when this little guy walked in.
I'm going to tell you where the first time I seen Eazy-E, it was at Bell High School.
Bell High School.
He was talking my shirt, Playboys in the Hood. And I play it once, and then it'll be over. I play something else, and come back and go, Playboys in the Hood.
Crazy.
Hey, Eazy-E, man. Hearing these guys talk, you know what I'm saying, you came from taking your records to high school parties and high school dances and stuff like that. You know, you've come a long way, and you've built an empire for yourself, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Now, what was the mentality that you had to think of to bring something to Los Angeles that they ain't never seen before? Something that, you know, no one would be able to imagine that a record could go number one on the Billboard charts without being getting any airplay or something like that.
I didn't believe in myself. It was all Greg's fault.
It was all Greg's fault, huh?
Yep.
Because they played stuff from the Panic Zone to Dope Man to Boys in the Hood and stuff like that.
Right.
What gave you the mentality? How did you come up with the concept of such a thing?
I said we all came up with the concept. Really, that's me, Dre, Yella, Ice Cube. We all came up with the concept. I'm not trying to take all the credits, you know.
Of course not. Of course not, man, because there's a lot of people that was involved and stuff like that. But now you got yourself an empire with Ruthless Records. You come up with your own records and stuff like that nowadays.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And we're looking for Eazy-E to come with a new record. When is that going to come through?
Now he's going to drop in a minute.
In a minute, huh? Yeah. About to go straight. All right, now check it out. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to go live and direct to the two turntables. Who's going to cut next, babe? Who's going to cut next for us?
I think I'm going to
cut. Julio.
Eazy-E's
going to cut for us.
He wants to mix Dope Man.
Julio G's gonna cut. Julio G's on the cut.
Now, what you gonna cut for us this afternoon?
I wanna do the fast stuff because somebody was calling in talking about, man, play the fast.
The original.
I wanna hear you scratch. Because I heard you played out.
Ah,
I wanna hear you scratch.
So, Julio G's gonna get on the one and two. Eric, we going to start it off with my man, Julio G. Greg Mack, introduce Julio G on the cut, man.
All right, my boy is just getting ready to get it all warmed up. He's rubbing his hands. He's got his arms. He's flexing them. Julio is running in there. He has the headphones. He's making a move for the tables. He's scratching. He's got it. I think he's doing it. Julio G on Power 106. When you used to do it back in the old days, you say on the tortillas. He's on there right now. It's Tony G of the Mix Masters.
On the wheels of steel, y'all. Great Mac and ass. Hey, yo, Tony G, go ahead and switch it up, man. Rock it like you know you all have to, bro. Come on. It is the OG original Mix Masters in the house, yo. We take it back to summertime, R9, yo. Cut it up. Tony G and Julio G on the Wheels of Steel, yo. On Power 106, yeah. live and direct on the 1 and 2. Julio G on the mix, y'all. It's live. Nothing taped here. The original KDY mix message, y'all.
The tables, and this is a part that you guys never get to see on the radio where Tony G flips the record. The record is like turned in half and he's scratching with it.
You mean he's bending it up like a taco?
Yeah, he's bending it up like a taco.
Is he gonna do it now?
He's gonna do it for us, right? This is his trademark, Tony G.
All the wheels are filled, y'all, live and direct as you've never seen it before. You are tuning in to Power 106, the K Day reunion in the house, giving respect to the original hip hop in Los Angeles, the ones that put it down from the get go. Tony G on the Woods and Fields right now, y'all. Two turntables, fool.
from the streets, from cap to fatigue.
With the original KDAY mix lessons, Mac Attack in the house. What's going on, man?
Hey, man, I'm just sitting here like reminiscing, you know what I'm saying? I also wanted to introduce you to our very only female mix master who's in the house.
I never got a chance to meet her. Herself. What's her name?
Lisa Ledesma. She used to get used on the air. What do we use? Christina?
Christina Lopez. Yeah. Or the mixtress, better known as the mixtress.
Is that right? You gonna get on the Wizard Sales Force tonight or what?
Yeah, if you guys let me, I'm down.
All right, well, you can get your cut on. We gonna show all the ladies that they do have skills out there in Los Angeles. Let's go live and direct to the phone line. Someone to give everybody a dab out there. We got somebody in the house. Who this?
Yo, this is Destructo, man.
Destructo, give your love to the KDAY Mix Masters, man.
Yeah, I'm giving it out to all of the listeners of Power 106, man. You guys are cutting it up today hard. We're chilling out in Beverly Hills, man.
Yeah, Beverly Hills is even listening to the KDAY Mix Masters. They'll be rocking like this. Tony G on the Wheels of Steel. We'll be right back after this. This is Power 106 with the Baker Boys Friday Night Flavors. Bringing it back the way it's supposed to be done. All right, Power 106. Hold on, y'all.
How shall I start this? Baker Boys, what's up? OC, time's up. Wild Pitch 94. Word up. We got to get some unity going out here, too. You know what I'm saying? It goes a one and a two and a three and across the California coast to the eastern shores. I violate scores of mics of all types of metal. Let's settle in and listen, cause you might be missing. Power 106 gives a fix of hip-hop gnosis, a dosis. Roll call, when I'm on the line, I manifest minds, lines, each and all time. No matter the coast, whether OG or high post. Everything's one love when the fat bastards are the host. So yo, time to make peace with the west and the east, cause the only one who wins is the beast. Let me say it again. Time to make peace with the west and the east, cause the only one who wins is the beast. Beast. Baker Boys, Power 106. In the mix.
Tired of hearing about World Cup? Do you even know what World Cup is?
Es algo milagroso.